So I have one little confession to make. I ended up spending $100 on the internet last night, all the fault of Chris, because me and my two girlfriends thought we would act like 16-year-olds, and we got on the internet plan and Googled Kris Kristofferson shirtless and spent about 15 minutes going, oh my God, look at that. And we were so frazzled by the end of it that we forgot to log out, so I spent $100 looking at him shirtless. They said it was very lucky. I went to the internet cafe today and said, I didn't know, I swear, I was just frazzled, and y'all give me back some of those minutes, so anyway. But more importantly, it's just truly amazing to be up here with such incredible talent, and our, I think we could all call him our hero mentor, doing this still at his age and doing it brilliantly. So it's very nice to have people our own age doing this and making a living out of it, and then to have someone like this next to us. So thank you guys for staying up so late. This is way past. The Williams family gets focused on a lot, which is fine, because it's my family, and I'm very proud of it, and I'm fine to talk about it, but I didn't know Hank Williams. He died in 1952, and I didn't really know anyone who knew him or was around him much. My dad was 3 years old when he died. So the grandparents that I spent all my time with were on my mom's side. They were cotton farmers from Louisiana, lived in a little town of 600 people called Marouge. Had four babies and went through a war and all the things you go through in a life together. And I lost both of them before this new album. And my granny was real slow, whether she was making biscuits or not, it took her a while to do anything. So this song is from my papa and my granny. This is called Waiting on June. Let's get it here. All right, here we go.
Get her hair cut, waiting on you. is listening to me. You walk on down to Sunday school. I'll be there in 15, waiting on you. Yeah, the sound blew by the cedar wood. Yeah, the kids grew fast to the farm. Did good in this bird that made our supper every day. We'd all say grace and dig on in. We always ate together in those days. Oh, one by one, those kids went off and found in love their home. Nothing like the joy I knew when they brought their babies home. We'd play all day in the cotton fields with the dogs I raised up around. It ends in grandma's kitchen.